celebrities just can't seem to get enough of pantsuits. Makes me wonder if it's become a safe choice for a celebrity stylist.
I mean, I agree with you, but we've seen a lot of celebrities trying their best to go for bolder and exaggerated version of this classic, but it is getting a little monotonous.
So today, it's going to be about how differently these pantsuits were styled in this episode of
Crush or Crash.
Okay, so first on the list is Isha Gupta, and she's wearing this off-white quad set from the same brand, but okay. It sort of somewhat looks like. So the blazer is from Kenzo at Bodymons, and the pants are from Herringbone and Sui. So it's of an off-white color, the duo, and I don't like it to begin with, because first of all, when I look at it, the fit and the silhouette is kind of off for me. Because since the blazer and the pants are of different texture, so that's sort of putting me off slightly. And the length of that blazer is just pissing me off to another level. I just don't like it. And also I have to mention that this look has been styled very poorly, like extremely. If you'll notice like the amount of jewelry she's wearing, like I have no problem if you're like loaded with jewelry. I love that stacked up look. But here, nothing belongs or matches with each other. Like she's wearing a silver watch and she has some bracelets and whatnot from H&M and Azatik is another brand that she's wearing. And you will see those heart earrings and a couple of necklaces and that clip also that she's wearing, the beaded ones that we're getting. And on top of that, like she has like very dramatic makeup and hair. It's not making sense for me. Like, so the styling is off, like the jewelry is completely not working for me, the pantsuit is ugly, and her hair and makeup is nice, like okay, working for her, but it's completely not supporting the look. So yeah, I don't like it.
Okay, a lot of points I agree with. The only thing that I'm okay with is the length of the blazer. I really like the oversized look in the long blazers with the flared pants, like semi-flared, not extremely flared.
Yeah.
But here the problem is the fit is a little awkward. The white looks very casual, very easy, but the styling has been overdone and nothing works.
Yeah.
Hair too made up. Those vintage curls with that clip, separately she's looking stunning. Like makeup and hair is beautiful on her. But is it working with the outfit? It's absolutely not. So I think we both know the answer.
Crashing it.
So next on the list is Mrunal Thakur. Again, one of her looks for the promotional look. Mrunal is wearing this beautiful candy pink color pantsuit by Julian Alvarez. Firstly, I love this photograph. This one is killing it. Like, look at that pose.
Yeah.
This pantsuit features a high-low uneven hem, I'd say. If you see, the left side is slightly shorter as compared to the right side. The right side's longer. It's a double-breasted jacket. And it has a nice ruffle detail, high-neck top underneath. So it's definitely a very statement look. It's nothing simple. You can see a lot of effort and style has been put to it. Like they were trying to make it look like a piece. So the color's beautiful, it looks lovely. I like how it's so full and packed that she's kept her hair and makeup very, very minimal to support that. So I love the nude look with just the wing to add that drama to the face, and I love the hair. It's so vintage. It's like there's a wet look, but they've kept the curls so clean and the hair is just behind the ear and kept back.
Yeah.
Very neat, no clutter whatsoever. And if you see, the only jewelry and the only bling that we see in this outfit is those earrings, which I would personally say is a little over. Like, I'm not a person who goes overboard, but it's working for her.
Yeah.
And those glasses.
On point.
I mean, there's nothing about this look that I don't like.
Yeah. Like I said, it's super exaggerated, and that's what the USP of this look is. Like how they went for the monotone thing here, just one color, different hints and hues and tints of pink, I would say. So the candy color pantsuit is on point. I love the structure of it and the
fit.
What do you say, fit of it, and everything is like so nice. I love the high-low hem detail happening, and the pockets are also like a little slanting, it's not straight. And that ruffle top is adding that, you know, more elements and more playfulness and more edginess to
character,
this entire character to it, exactly. And on top of that, she has those beautiful earrings on, and that hairstyle is something that we need to talk about, guys. Like, it is so nicely done. I like how sleek it is and how like curly it is at the ends, and still it is so wet. And so that's really interesting. And since the hair was doing all the talking, they kept the makeup pretty simple. And she's looking fantastic. And we both are crushing it. Okay, so next in the list is Shayoni Gupta. And she's wearing this pantsuit by Melodrama. And I have to say, the outfit is clearly very dramatic, like over-dramatic. Oh my god. It's just getting to me, guys. It's too much to handle. So it's a stripe pantsuit.
Overall.
Over head to toe, it's strong, guys. And it's yellow, orange, red, white, and all these colors happening. And I have to say, it's quite
bad.
It's quite bad. Like, I'm really, like, because she's going so beautiful. Like, her face is just, so I want to kiss that face, but that pantsuit is just killing me from inside. It looks like those night suits that mama used to buy me when I was a kid, guys. And abhi bhi, if you see, like, all these.
I like that night suit, yeah. I don't mind those loose shorts.
So night suit kisi ne pehni ka hai na, to ye aise kyun, why did they give this a form of a pantsuit? Because it's clearly not doing justice to the category of pantsuits and the stripes. Because I honestly love stripes. It's wearing stripes, but this is just a disaster, like a horrendous disaster. The colors are not looking, it's just looking funny to me. It's like a clown outfit turned into a sober outfit. Silhouette, I would say. But it's clearly not working. And coming to the makeup and hair, simple. Like, I love how she's just glowing. Can you see that sheen on her face? The makeup is so, it's like brown tones and, like, you know, working wonderfully on her skin tone. And, like, her hair is actually sort of making it cute because it's short and, like, you know,
she's very playful.
Exactly. She's a very different beauty. She's not a conventional beautiful woman. She's very different and she's just perfection, dude.
Firstly, the colors, too many colors. It's super funny. Firstly, you can't give me such a bothering print. Ki main aapko dekhi nahi paun, toh what's the point, right? Then something as fun and quirky as that, with the colors and the print that they went for, it's put on a very, very formal outfit. So they haven't even played with the silhouette. It's a basic pantsuit and no shelf, nothing, no break from the stripe. I just feel it's too much for one person to take in. Upar se, obviously nude pumps, she's looking stunning because she is. But choice of outfit is just so, so bad. Nothing can be done about it. So, crashing it for sure.
Crashing it, guys.
So, next on the list is Nora Fatehi. Obviously, we know her as the Gulbar girl. So, she's wearing this white on white pantsuit from Zara and she's styled it with a corset inside, which is also white, from Meshki. And styled it with, like, button earrings, gold button earrings and nude pumps. Now, coming to this look as compared to Isha Gupta's look, I actually like how neat and how elegant they've kept this look. Like, I can see every structure. The white is too pristine and very rich. I would have preferred the corset to be fuller. The blazer is a little too loose. And if you see, and it's long, it's more like an overcoat blazer look with the pants. But other than that, it looks amazing. I like how she's kept her makeup neat, center parted hair, long, and just that, like, red lip for the pop of color. It's a very simple look, but it's working for me. She looks stunning and it's well styled.
Yeah. So here she went for, like, white, like a rich white, which I'm loving. It's just like sort of, it's a kill rana skipper, which is really nice. She went white on white on white, which is like another monotone look that we have seen in the list today. And she paired it up with those beige heels and red lips and those button earrings and long hair, center parted, straightened. Very, like, nothing interesting, like nothing new, I would
over
say.
The top.
Yeah, but she is looking absolutely hot in it. So it's simple, but it's effective. So I think we both are crushing it. Okay, so next on the list is Kangana Ranaut, who has gone horribly wrong yet again with her looks, because it's quite shit. Why is she wearing that? I don't
know.
Niche se kya hai, upar se Batman, Batwoman. I really fail to understand what is this silhouette. And the crotch is looking pretty weird. The sleeves are looking damn bad. The cigarette pants, I am crashing. And with that, Obala mujhe shoes pehne hain. Usko to hum matlab rehne nahi dete. It is just killing me from inside. It's looking like pajami, the churidar pajami the auntie wears now with sandals.
I can see gathers in the bottom, so
it's
I don't understand.
Sad. And makeup, she kept her makeup pretty simple and natural
curls. Makeup and hair is like hot.
Yeah, but outfit is quite a disappointment.
Yeah. Firstly, it took us so long to understand that these are three different pieces. The shirt is the same print. It has exaggerated collars. Then she has a jacket with a lapel, which is sitting around the same collar thing. It's a cutout sleeve. I don't understand why did we need a cutout feature with a bell. And the bell also comes with layers. It literally looks like that chidiya ke pankh jab aise kharab nahi ho jate jaise udte matlab pata nahi jo bhi ho gaya hai kafi scene kharab ho chuka hai. So that it gives a very frayed look, which is not looking nice. It's looking untidy.
Yeah.
So the print is way too much. There is no distinction to her silhouette and the pieces that she's wearing. The pants are very ill-fitted. I'm not even talking about the fit for the top. Like, the pants are horrible. Imagine how long her legs are. Why would you do that to her? If pajami ke upar kurta bhul diye. But other than that, hair and makeup, she's looking really hot. And I love Kangana in her natural hair. So that is perfect. But other than that, the outfit is horrendous. The shoes don't work at all. And I'm super crashing it. Not just
crashing it.
So last on the list is Manushi Chiller. She is Miss World 2017. So this I think was a day event. So she chose to go for a red on red pantsuit with no shelf in sight, like we were talking earlier. It's a very simple look, but I love the choice of the color. Firstly, she's stunning. She's so beautiful and such a cute, pretty face. The color is very nice for afternoon. I think the best part is that the color on its own is such a statement that you don't have to do much to enhance it. I actually like that it was a smart idea to keep the rest of her styling very muted, be it her makeup, which is extremely nude. It's almost a fresh face makeup with glossy lips, center parted hair. She's kept it clean, gone almost nothing when it comes to her accessories. And the only addition was the snake print strappy sandals, which actually works. I mean, I kind of like the contrast. It kind of works for her. Also, what works for me is the fit. She didn't go for the flared one. She went for the classic pantsuit silhouette. It's a straight cut.
So for me also, like, color is fantastic. It's red and one color that we all love and like love to wear. And I love the fit of it, love the color, and how she actually went for nothing inside. It's just the pantsuit that is the center of attraction here. And she paired it up with those really tiny hoop earrings. If you'll notice, like, it's like not even there.
Yeah.
The snake print sandals are working wonderfully. It's like a nice contrast against the red. You have a print against a solid red color. So that's a very smart thing to do. And she kept her hair extremely natural. I think it's blow dry bhi kara hai, nahi kara hai, I really don't know, because it's looking so natural. And love the no makeup look. The hair is nice and so everything is on point. Like, there's nothing major to talk about it, because she's looking absolutely stunning. That is she, like, that's the reason she became Miss World, guys. I'll be kidding. But yeah, I love the look, love her, and we both are crushing it. That was it for this episode, guys. Let us know what you thought of it in the comment section below.
And while you do that, don't forget to check out the POPxo shop. They've got amazing merchandise like fanny pack, coffee mugs, scented candles, doormats, and a lot more. The link is in the description box, so click on it and shop now.
And for more styling tips and tricks and news on celebrity looks, keep watching POPxo Daily.